Hey, I'm Justin, and I am super excited that you are joining me again for Tell Me About. And today, we're talking about turtles. I think turtles are super interesting animals. So let's explore why they're so cool and what makes a turtle a turtle. Now, first things first, there's more than one kind of turtle. There's more than two kinds of turtles. More than three, or four, or... Well, why don't I show you? You've got your box turtle, snapping turtle, loggerhead turtle, green sea turtle, hawksbill, olives ridley, Kemp's ridley, flatback, leatherback, big-headed turtle, spotted turtle, blandlings, European pond turtle, bogwood, spotted box turtle, map turtle, diamondback terrapin, red-bellied cooter, pond slider, northern river terrapin, painted terrapin, brown-roofed turtle, Asian leaf turtle, spiny turtle, giant tortoise!
Oh, I gotta breathe. I gotta breathe. Whew. Did you know that there are over 300 different kinds of turtles in the world? So you could see that I'd be here a while if I said all of them.
Turtles are reptiles, and reptiles are cold-blooded. That means they can't regulate their body temperature without a little help. So to warm up, they need to stand in the sun, and to cool off, they gotta get out of the sun and into the water or shade. These turtles are out sunning themselves, soaking up the rays. This one's all like, oh, it's too hot. I gotta, oh, that's nice. Oh, and this one over here is gonna stretch a little bit to get more sun, but oh, your legs are in my face, oh. One of the main cool things about turtles is that they have this thing on their back. What's it called? That's right, a shell. Here's what this turtle shell looks like. And here's this one. And here's this one too. Now, let me ask you guys a question. Who here likes to watch cartoons? Raise your hand if you do. I know I do. Now, I remember seeing some old cartoons where a turtle got so scared that he jumped out of his shell and ran away. It was really funny, but it's impossible. Well, why is that? Well, it's because a turtle's shell is basically its ribs and backbone. Only instead of being on the inside of their body like ours are, it's on the outside. Why don't you take your hands for a second and feel your rib cage? It's right about here. And then take a hand and feel your backbone or your spine. Now, could you jump out of your body and leave your bones behind? No, of course not. At least, gosh, I hope not. So, turtles always have their shell on, like how we always have our bones on. Now, just because they can't jump out of the shell doesn't mean they can't do cool things with it. Here's something that some turtles are able to do. They can tuck their head and their limbs inside their shell, like this. This helps the turtle stay safe. Let's say that you're a big animal and you want to take a bite out of this tortoise, right? So all of a sudden, you just have this big hard shell in front of you that looks pretty tough to crack, and you can't really take a bite out of it. Doesn't look too appetizing, right? Some turtles, like painted turtles and sliders, live near the water, like lakes, rivers, and ponds. Like all turtles, they need to breathe air though, so when they're not swimming, they'll crawl on up to the logs and rocks on the shore and sunbathe, like we learned earlier. They mostly eat plants, but sometimes they'll eat insects and small fish. During the cold winter months, they'll dig deep into the muddy bottom of the water and snooze, or hibernate, until the warm weather comes. Some turtles, like this box turtle, live on the forest floor. That's where they'll find their delicious meals of berries and insects, roots, flowers, and other plants. During winter, they too will find a nice cozy place to sleep or hibernate until spring. Some turtles spend their whole lives underwater. These are sea turtles. A sea turtle is built for life in the ocean. Their long flippers act like paddles that push them through the water, and they can dive very deep to get to their favorite food, jellyfish. Now, like other turtles, sea turtles need to breathe air, but they can hold their breath for a really long time. An adult sea turtle can hold its breath for up to 45 minutes underwater. That's a really long time. But if the water is really cold and a sea turtle's body slows down, a large sea turtle can hold its breath for up to 7 hours. That's like watching 40 of these videos. Imagine sitting down and watching 40 of these videos with me in them and holding your breath the whole time. Please don't do that. I mean, of course you couldn't do that and you wouldn't do that, but a sea turtle could. All turtles lay eggs. Female sea turtles come out of the water to lay their eggs on the beach. And when the eggs hatch, they have to hurry and scurry back into the ocean waters. Hey, you want to know what the biggest turtle in the world is? Here it is, the leatherback sea turtle. Here you can see it next to a person. Wow, that's big. Here's an interesting thing about the leatherback sea turtle. It's called that because its shell isn't hard like other turtles. No, it's more like a soft, rubbery leather.
Showtime!
What's that sound?
It's showtime!
Showtime! Okay. I got a really good one. It's about turtles. Okay. What did the teenage turtle use to call his mom? His shell phone. Ooh, I cracked myself up. Oh my God. Shouldn't have done that. That's my mic. Now, finally, this is a tortoise. Tortoises are a kind of turtle too. Only tortoises only live on land. No, they can't be bothered with oceans or rivers or any of that. So, you have your small tortoises and your medium tortoises, and then you have your giant tortoise. Look at this guy, that's a giant tortoise. And look, this is a giant tortoise's foot, and this is a giant tortoise's face, and you got a little sun there, whatever. Giant tortoises can live a really long time too. They can live to be well over 100 years old. Thanks so much for exploring turtles with me today. I hope you had as much fun as I did, and I hope you know so much more about these amazing reptiles. I'll see you next time on our Tell Me About series, where we explore our beautiful natural world. And until then, remember to always be clever. Hey.